What's up, y'all? It's your boy 15 Moves Ahead coming to you with another video. Listen, I hope you're ready for this because this is going to be very deep. Okay, I titled the video The Iron Cross of War, and you might be saying to yourself, why did he label this The Iron Cross of War? Number each arm of the cross and then show a warrior. What does this mean, 15 Moves Ahead? Well, let me break this down to you. In the 33 strategies of war, the first form of warfare, self-directed warfare, the pink pages. Remember, I did a video the other day about the pink pages in the 33. The first pink page is self-directed warfare. There are four steps to self-directed warfare. It's called the Iron Cross because the cross has four arms, and each arm represents a particular element that you yourself have to embody. You have to purify these elements. You have to integrate these elements. So since we are talking about self-directed warfare, what better shape to use than a cross? An Iron Cross, we know, is associated with war. So we're going to go to war with ourselves. Look at the warrior. We're going to go to war with ourselves. And the first step in this war is called the polarity strategy. Now check this out. Because we're dealing with the number four, we're also dealing with the four elements. And in Robert Greene's book, The 33 Strategies of War, each first four strategies has an element attributed to it. Let me show you. Go to the first strategy, the polarity strategy. Go to the back, look at the image. The image is the earth. Now the earth is symbolic with a foundation and grounding, stability. The earth is also something that you would use to find yourself. This is symbolic. This is the symbolism of the earth. So is it any wonder why the first strategy is titled the polarity strategy? Because when you have the polarity strategy, you are dealing with an inner enemy and an outer enemy. In the 33 strategies of war, the first strategy deals with an inner enemy and an outer enemy. So this means you are going to fight yourself, and then you are going to fight outside of yourself. Remember the Ethiopian proverb, if there is no enemy within, there can be no enemy without. So the first strategy, the polarity strategy, will help you find your footing. This will help you gain your foundation. This will help you start to see yourself as you need to see yourself, which can then polarize you from everything else outside of you. The second strategy is titled, Do Not Fight the Last War, the Guerrilla War of the Mind Strategy. And guess what? If you go to the second strategy in the 33 strategies of war and you look up the image, the image is water. Water is the element associated with the second strategy, water. Because the fresher, the faster the water flows, the clearer it gets. This is how your emotions got to be no matter what you are dealing with. This is why it says do not fight the last war. Because you are trying to use tactics and things that happen in other situations, and you are attributing that to your present situation, and you can't do that. You cannot take something that worked a year ago, 5 years ago, last week, 2 months ago, hell, even 2 hours ago, and apply it to right now. You must take every person, every situation, every employment opportunity as it is, as it is being in front of you. It is fresh. And this is what causes a lot of us to lose, because we are not able to adapt in the moment. We are steady trying to use what happened in the past. We have preconceived ideas. And this is why in the second strategy, he clearly tell you it is not that you was lacking knowledge. It was your inability to stay present in the moment and deal with everything that's in front of you right now. You're so stuck trying to use the past to deal with the present that the future became confusing and daunting. So we have to remember the second strategy is element is water. We're fighting ourselves right now. We're not worrying about other people. The third strategy is titled Amidst the Turmoil of Events, the Counterbalance. Do not lose your presence of mind, the Counterbalance strategy. And guess what element is associated with the third strategy. You guessed it, the wind. The wind is associated with the third strategy because no matter what's going on around you, you cannot have that chaotic mindset. You got to be clear. You got to be present in the moment and right now. Yes, I might have financial situations. Yes, I might have relationship situations. Yes, I might have employment situations, but I'm going to deal with what's in front of me and not worry about tomorrow or yesterday. I can only deal with right now. And see, a lot of us go to the side, we go astray because we are spending our time trying to deal with stuff that happened the other day or that happened to someone else or that we think could happen, or we're projecting our fear out in front of us and saying, hey, I really don't know about this scenario. You're sitting up here playing all these different permutations. You're trying to figure things out and, you know, peak game and all this other stuff you're trying to do, when what you have in front of you is what you need to deal with and what you need to look at and what you need to focus on. And this is what we have to do amidst the turmoil of events, the chaos, everything that's going on around you. Do not lose your presence of mind. You have to be like the air, like the wind. It comes and goes and you don't see it, you don't hear it, but you feel it. You can hear it sometimes, but my point is that it's not in one place, but it is everywhere. So your thoughts got to be centered and you have to understand what's in front of you. And here we go. My favorite strategy, I ain't gonna lie. Number 4, create a sense of urgency and desperation. The death ground strategy. There's only one element left, and that's fire. Fire is the image to the fourth strategy in the 33. Open your book, look at the page, you'll see it for yourself. So if fire is the image to the fourth strategy, and the fourth strategy is titled, do not create a sense of urgency and desperation. The fourth strategy is titled, create a sense of urgency and desperation, the death ground strategy. And it gives you the story about Cortez, but you can read the stories by yourself. I just want to hit the elements and apply it to me. So if I'm going to create a sense of urgency and desperation and I'm given the element of fire, man, fire purifies and fire cleans. Remember, fire is the only element, when it is associated with the other elements, it purifies and it changes their form. You put fire with earth, it becomes dust. You put fire with water, it becomes steam. You put fire with wind, air, it becomes condensation. So fire is that thing that you must put underneath you to go. You got to go through whatever you have in front of you. You have to deal with whatever you're seeing, and you got to get so hungry and so urgent and so desperate that you see nothing else but that thing in front of you. Fire consumes, it consumes, it consumes, it goes fast, it goes fast, it's hot, it consumes. But once it has something to feed on, oh, it's over. But when it has nothing to feed on, it dissipates. And in the fourth strategy, he's telling you how some of you have that cousin, that relative, that job, that safety net, and you're afraid to go all in on something. So if I in my life feel like there's something I should be doing, if I in my life feel like there's a particular direction I need to be taking, if I in my life feel like there's something I'm supposed to be seeing, yet I don't do it, then that means I'm not desperate enough. That's why you don't win. That's why you don't get ahead, because you're not desperate enough. You don't have enough fire, that hunger. You don't have the mentality that it's either all or nothing. And in the story, Cortez, they burned the ships. They poked holes and burned the ships. And they was on the island of Hispaniola, which is present day Dominican Republic in Haiti. And they had nothing else but to go forward and win. And they won. Your mind state got to be the same way. So this is why it's called the Iron Cross of War, because we need to go to war with ourselves. We need to apply the polarity strategy. We need to apply the death ground strategy. We need to apply the guerrilla war of the mind strategy, and we need to apply the counterbalance strategy. All four strategies, we need to fight ourselves before we even try to go out into the world and start employing different tactics and different type of war strategies on people, places, and things, when we have to get ourselves right. So that's why it's called the Iron Cross of War. I told y'all this, it was gonna get good. Thank you for watching. Don't forget, check me out on Patreon. You want a consultation with me, hit me up, www.15movesahead.com. I'm here. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. I'm out.